Radio 93.7, also live streaming via our parish Facebook page. We are about to begin the celebration of the 11 a.m. Mass for the second Sunday of Lent. A reminder to anyone who may be ready for this from the parking lot, at communion time, the ministry will come out to the covered walkway and distribute communion to anyone ready for this from the parking lot. At that time, please come forward to receive communion and kindly return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For any unable to come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway and a minister will bring communion to you while you are in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly.
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We call on our God to save us, to show us the way home. For the times we have failed, the times we have sinned, we call these to mind and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
House to a land I will show.
Peter, James, and John, his brother, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Lord, it is good that we are here. One, let us, if you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Rise and do not be afraid." When the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, "Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Last week, in Matthew's Gospel, we heard that following his baptism by his cousin, John the Baptist, Jesus was led by the Spirit, that same Spirit who descended upon him like a dove at the time of his baptism, this time led by the Spirit into the desert, fasting for 40 days and nights, and being tested and tempted by Satan. And perhaps last week we also learned something about being tempted and tested. That is, something that informed us that it's not necessarily something that's really bad. Plus, of course, we give in to the testing and the temptation. Rather, being tempted or tested not only makes manifest the fragility of our humanness, but as a result can be that catalyst that drives us to lean more deeply on God, to trust more deeply in God's help. But we also learn that there's a second good that comes from being tempted or tested, and it's that it provides us with some direction in life. It makes clearer to us those areas in life that we are tempted and tested in to be those areas that require our attention, to take some action in our lives. My friends, let me suggest that this weekend's gospel, the account of the transfiguration, really presents to us another temptation, another test. Certainly for Peter, as well as James and John, but also for us. And it's not Satan who's doing the tempting or testing. Rather, it's Jesus himself. Jesus did not allow them to witness his transfiguration with ill motives. He allowed Peter, James, and John to witness his transfiguration so that they might better understand what awaits those who are faithful to his call, to his message, to his purpose, to his way of life. And perhaps at the time, he didn't even realize that it would become a temptation and a test for them. Peter's response to the vision betrays this temptation. "Lord, it's good that we're here. If you wish, I can make three tents." And add to this the voice that comes from that cloud, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." And the entire experience brings Peter, James, and John to the ground. Peter and those with him now know something more than they knew before about Jesus. interesting when you put Moses and Elijah at his side, the law and the prophets. Peter and the others now recognize Jesus for who he truly is. The fulfillment of what God had promised the Israelites for centuries, the very holy of holies in the flesh. Presence of God in the flesh. And Peter and the others, as good Jews, with great respect, want nothing more than to house the Holy of Holies. Nothing more than to house God, as they had done for centuries in housing the Torah. This experience brought Peter, James, and John great joy and a tremendous amount of comfort. A joy and a comfort that understandably they wanted to hold on to. A joy and a comfort they wanted to contain. And therein lies their temptation. Their test. Frankly, I have been there. It would be a temptation and a test for me, as I'm sure it might be for you. But Jesus could not allow this. He couldn't allow it for them. He couldn't allow it for himself because he wasn't done with his mission yet. A mission that was to be shared with Peter, James, and John, and others, and a mission that still lay ahead of them. And it wasn't going to take place on some glorious mountain, but down on the plain where the lives of many still hungered and thirsted for good news. Hungered and thirsted for redemption, hungered and thirsted for the promise. My friends, you and I will find ourselves at times in very, very good places in our lives. Certainly places that bring us joy, places that provide us with comfort. And indeed, these places and times that God brings to us and wants us to have and experience are good. They provide for us a glimpse of what's yet to be. But much like the experience of the Transfiguration, certainly for Jesus, but also for Peter, James, and John, we need to remember that there's work that remains to be done. A work that takes place in the plains of our lives. Our lives and the lives of others. A work that involves us. And it's a work that is messy at times, even painful, but also ever so necessary. Oh, there will be times where we will be tempted to remain in our comfortable place, in our place of joy. We'll be tempted not to move from the mountain in that experience, but move from it we must. And we bring with it that memory of what the experience of joy was, what the experience of comfort was. But we also bring with it Jesus. Jesus who leads us down the mountain into the very plains of our lives. Jesus who stays with us. Jesus who accompanies us in the messiness of daily living. Jesus who has promised to the faithful, that we will be brought to a time of eternal comfort, a time of eternal joy. We will return to that holy mountain one day for all eternity. May our prayer this day and always be guided by our confidence in the gospel and the strength provided us by God in Jesus Christ.
That all who suffer in service of the gospel may experience the transfiguration of Jesus as pledge of Paschal mystery, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who now live in the land sacred to all Abraham's descendants may work together to secure the blessings of a lasting and just peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have fled their homelands or been driven away from them may find solace, compassion, and refuge from people of goodwill throughout our world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the elect of the church, along with the candidates for full initiation, and candidates for confirmation and the reception of First Communion, may listen to the voice of God's Son, the Beloved, and share in the blessings promised to Abraham and all the families of the earth, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our own candidates for confirmation on retreat today may draw closer to Christ in this time of preparation and in the years ahead, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, loving others, and becoming and making disciples, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who hunger for meaning may draw closer to Christ and place him at the center of our lives, and any missing from our assembly or other church communities may be led through the desert to a renewal of their lives, welcomed by us and others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and homebound of our community, especially Fred Burkhart, John Chacabino, Bob Christian, Danny Berg, Floss Berg, Mike Berg, Deja Kirby, Julian Jenkins, Dan Lane, Tom Larkowski, Joyce Moore, Dora Kutroki, Brooke Russell, Carol Scally, Katrina Shunk, Paula Simmons, Clara Whitus, John Wright, as well as the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may know the healing touch of Jesus who can transfigure their suffering and cast out their fear, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Eva Tolini, mother of Tony, who has recently died, and all our beloved dead, may live forever in the transfiguration glory of Christ.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be confident God will provide for the needs that remain deep in our minds and hearts, as well as those written in our prayer notebook and those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To Abraham and Sarah, you call out, O God of mystery, inviting them to journey to the land of promise. To us also you call out, inviting us to pass through Lent to Easter's glory. Open our ears to listen to Jesus, your beloved Son, in whom you are well pleased, embracing the mystery of the cross. May we come to the Holy Mount, to immortal life, and to share in Christ's transfigured glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant, we sing together, There Is a Longing, and the number 405.
There is a longing in our hearts.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults, and sanctify our faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities, through Christ our Lord. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing their mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in the new heaven and in the new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed.
This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Communion chant, let's sing together, "Stay with us, O Lord," number 403. Can we sing the first refrain, "Stay with us, O Lord, walk beside us on our journey"?
Earth within us.
receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us, while still on earth, to be partakers even now of the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A constant thank you to all giving of their time, their talent, certainly a treasure to the Portland Parish's mission and ministry. As we always do, envelope users, please remember to use the collection boxes at the entrance of the church. Remember that throughout the season of Lent, through and including Holy Thursday, we continue to collect alms to help support the Talented Good Neighbors mission and ministry, as well as Blessed Trinity Food Pantry. At the end of the season, we'll just divide those funds in half, and they will be between the two. So thank you for your generosity. If you can also remember to use Faith Direct to make a contribution to that as well. Don't forget your bulletins as you leave, and take fines or in the entrance to the church. There's a couple inserts in the bulletin that I want to draw your attention to. One is, we published a statement from Bishop Valesik, Bishop of our diocese, that was put out in his comments and statement on the evil and sin of racism. So we encourage you to take to heart the message he has to convey to us. There's another insert I'll speak about in a moment. Always a reminder to check the bulletin for opportunities for prayer and spiritual enrichment throughout this holy season of Lent, as well as the parish Lent and Easter mailing. This Wednesday evening, every parish of the Diocese of Cleveland, including Our Lady of Victory, will be open from 5 to 8 p.m. It's an evening of confession that's diocesan-wide. This has been going on for several years now, and it continues. So certainly you can take advantage of that, but it originally started and it has been very positive in terms of response to welcome those back who have been away for a while. So, you know, certainly this is a season of inviting people back to the Lord Jesus. So use that opportunity. There are Lenten resources that remain on tables near the entrance of the church, and it's really time to get your alms in, so please do so. The Parish Center offices will be closed tomorrow. They will reopen at 1 p.m. tomorrow. That's Monday. And it's not a problem for the 5 p.m. people, but for 8:30 and 11, remember to turn your clocks ahead next weekend. Masses, I'm sure we're going to be seeing people coming and going and at all sorts of times. But if you change your clock, you'll be here on time. So that's next Sunday. Also next Sunday, March 12th, is a Lenten afternoon of reflection from 2 to 5 p.m. with Miguel Chavez and his twin brother, P.J. Chavez. Check the Lent Easter mailing for information, but also a bulletin insert that's in there this week. It's great, a great opportunity just to pause and reset. So we look forward to having you, others as well, and bring a friend. And last but not least, mark your calendars. Church spring cleaning will take place. The first date is March 24th. An alternate date, if needed, is Friday, March 31st. And what I would ask is our confirmation candidates to please come forward and stand for the foot of the altar. They're on retreat today. They're very shy and bashful. You can spread out and eat. Let's make this a Kodak moment. I walked in before they were playing some sort of game, and if I knew the game, I hadn't played. I don't know. Well, first of all, it's just a blessing to have you with us. These people have been praying for you, will continue to pray for you. But what I ask of you right now is to bow your heads as I offer a prayer on your behalf with their intention as well. Good and gracious God, you have given us the gift of Blessed Carlo Acutis. He's patron of computer programmers, but also a patron of youth. At age 15, he has set an example with his life for so many. Through his intercession and his blessing, fill these individuals with the gift of your spirit, the gift of your peace, the gift of your love. Help them to be conformed more and more to the image and likeness of your Son, and in the spirit of Carmel, draw closer to him in the Holy Eucharist. We pray for them and for their families as they continue their preparation and their formation, and look forward to that day when the fullness of the Holy Spirit comes upon them. You who are Father, Son, and Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
So that they may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty he showed in his own life to the amazement of his apostles. Through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And let's sing together, Christ before us.